YouTube fam, welcome back to another week of Married at First Sight. We are still in season 11, and this episode was episode 14, Stranger Spouse. Once again, my name is Blythe.
And I'm Brandon, and if you haven't done so already, okay, make sure, take that time now, smash the subscribe button, and hit the bell so that you get post notifications so you know whenever we drop new content, okay? We are almost close to 1K. I think we're about 50 maybe subscribers out. We're this close, guys. Help us out if you haven't done so already. A lot of you watching are not subscribed to the channel. Help us make that final push to 1K so we can go ahead and hit that milestone and we can do the 1K giveaway, okay? Stay tuned for details on that. While you're at it, smash that like button. That lets YouTube know that you're enjoying our content. They'll continue to push it out to more people. It'll help us grow as a channel. And the more we grow, the more we can bring more content to you guys, okay? Hop in the comments, okay? We love to go back and forth with you guys in the comment section. We have interesting discussions, to say the least. Mm-hmm. So hop in the comments. Other than that, we're gonna go ahead and get started.
Let's go. All right. So let's move on now to Woody and Imani. Woody and Imani, again, they're doing good. They basically, you know, again, it showed them packing up, getting ready to go on the trip. You know Woody, he got his bandana outfit on, his short set. Always ready.
He was looking like a Dipset video from 2000 and...
He was fresh.
Yeah. Had that going.
Yeah. They had a good trip, good travels. Of course, they always get along. They had good conversation. Again, they were kind of like the experts pulling everybody together.
Yeah.
The conversations, even the couple's conversations at the table, they pretty much headed all of that, didn't they? Kind of led it.
Yeah.
Get everyone talking and conversation going.
Yeah. Yeah, they did.
Yeah, I mean, they're still on a good track. They're good.
I don't really know. Yeah, I'm trying to think of anything of interest that really happened.
They were really helping everybody else in their conversations. They just kind of talked about what, in the end, they were saying what could make you say no or something, like and they just kind of talked about that.
I mean, their producers gave them that.
That's true. Because there's no way anybody seeing them say no.
No.
Mm-hmm. That's true.
But, you know, they tried to come up with, you know, whatever, mm-hmm. to keep the suspense just a little bit. Because a slight bit of suspense. But there's no suspense. We know Woody and Imani are good.
Yeah.
They're awesome. Like, they display a maturity when it comes to marriage that it takes a lot of couples, I think, years to achieve. So, kudos to them. And I just hope that they continue to have success in the future. Hope they say yes on decision day. And I think they should have either a spinoff or they should start their own YouTube channel, without a doubt. So
they're our favorites.
For
definitely.
Sure.
All right. Well, that's it for Woody and Imani. All right. Now, Bennett and Amelia. So once again, they're doing pretty good. They packed, got down to their cabin. They're excited. They did really good with the couples, basically in all the group settings and the conversations. They were good. They did have a segment where they did ask them to write a letter to your younger self. That was a little hiccup there. For Amelia, Bennett... I think Bennett was trying to understand where she was coming from. He was...
Well, you know, I think they just kind of, they approached it differently. So Amelia kind of approached it like, you know, in light of her meeting Bennett, you know, she kind of addressed the letter in that way. Like, hey, you're going to meet this great guy. Yeah. You're going to get on this show. You should definitely go for it. And Bennett, different people think differently.
Yeah.
I don't think it was necessarily wrong.
No.
In his mind... him meeting Amelia and it, like, it's a sure thing. It's awesome. It's great. I need to tell my younger self about something else. Like, I'm not even worried about that. Like, that's a done dollar. And he said, you know, I wouldn't want to ruin the surprise for my younger self, you know, it's married at first sight.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? So the whole experience, like, that's part of the experience, is not knowing the person and getting to know them. Not, hey, you're gonna go on Married at First Sight, but don't worry about it. They're amazing. She's amazing. Well, that kills all the suspense building up to it. Like, his living his entire life knowing I don't have to date anybody. I don't have to do anything. When I get on the show, it's all kosher. I'm not nervous. Like, oh, cool, I'm about to go meet my, you know, so that's the way he looks at it. And I understand that.
A Pokemon card?
Pokemon cards are, yeah, look, those have value.
Okay, they do have value, but that was like so big to express.
Well, this is a letter to his younger self. When I was in middle school, Pokemon meant the world to me.
Middle school.
What?
Middle school.
What?
You just said middle school.
Right.
Okay, who said this is a middle schooler reading this letter?
It was a letter to your younger self.
Okay.
My younger self was upset.
Okay, it could be elementary, middle, high, but I don't know. That's cool. Difference of opinion, different way you think. I was with Amelia. I didn't say it had to be about her, but a Pokemon card. Yeah, I didn't get that either.
Men are from Mars, women are
absolutely from Venus. Absolutely, because that was like, that was what was most important that we need to talk about. I mean,
I
still think they're good. I still have hope for them. But, you know, it just probably lets Amelia know everything's not rosy and perfect, homegirl. And it's going to be some days where, you're going to have to let a little Bennett know. I mean, the doctors did say that the last, you know, episode two about standing up for herself and speaking up for herself too. So, because it's probably going to be some moments where Bennett is off on Mars and he's going to need to come back to Earth with it. You know what I mean? It's going to be something crazy. That's what I'm, you know what I mean? Like, he's going to have the little girl doing something crazy. She's going to be like, Bennett, now come on. We can't be doing that. He's going to be like, oh, I was letting her express herself. I thought it was great.
I think Amelia, for the most part, is going to be on board with most of that.
They're going to get along. I'm just saying, it's going to be the moments where she's going to have to pull them back and get them together. Especially, and you know, people change too. Lives change, people change. If Bennett stays in his segment, he'll change a little bit. We'll see. But Amelia being in that professional medical setting, you never know. Yeah. But not that it's a bad thing, but
I think they'll,
because she was kind of in the clouds, like in the clouds with it, like, oh, and it's just like, but maybe she needed that kind of bring it down to reality moment.
Like I said, you know, the directions were not like specific, like, hey, write a letter to your younger self about meeting your future spouse.
Yeah, we don't know what the directions were. I don't know. Just say, write a letter to your younger self.
Different people are different at different stages in their life. Like, men are far less mature. We mature more slowly than y'all.
True facts.
So, you know what I mean? Their younger self, she probably was concerned about who she's going to be in the future. His younger self was concerned about Pokemon cards. That's all we'd be thinking about. Like, video games, Pokemon cards, whatever we're into.
Mm-hmm. Even if it's... You know what? Guess what? Some grown man, too. So...
Very true. Very true.
Going into.
I'm not still interested in Pokemon cards. Okay. She's not talking about me. Alright.
But it's out there. It is. The great thing though was in the beginning, they did reveal that they have been spending time in Virginia. Wow. I was like, that's what's up. That's awesome.
That's dope. That's
like
crazy.
They've already been out there, like exploring, checking things out. I guess you think they've been like looking for a place and stuff like that.
Yeah.
So I said, wow, like, it's looking up. Like,
I think it's safe to say that they're going to say yes on decision day. That's pretty much a foregone conclusion, being that he has moved to Virginia.
They've already been up there checking it out. So that's what's up. All right. Well, that's it for Bennett and Amelia. Right, well, that's it for this video.
Haven't done so already, smash that subscribe button. We are almost at 1K. When we hit 1K, we'll be doing the 1K giveaway, okay? So stay tuned for details on that. Smash the like button that lets YouTube know that you're enjoying our content.
Yes.
Hop in the comments, guys. Let us know how you feel about this week's episode. Hop in there with us. And stay tuned. We're gonna be doing The Bachelorette just started.
Yes.
We haven't really watched this show before, but so we're kind of hopping onto
it. It's been years for me, but yeah.
You used to watch it. I've never watched this mess. We started watching it the other night and it's a hot mess, so I'm interested in seeing how that's gonna go. So stay tuned. That's probably gonna drop Sunday, and we got some other shows coming soon. Other than that,
that's it
for this week, guys.
Yep.